Hi everyone, it's Alexis from Sims VIP. I hope you're all doing well. Here I am with part two of my mods, aka cheats video. The first part, which is linked below, went over some of the basics about mods, what they do, how to install them, what to look out for. And this video is going to go through some of the options that some of these awesome mods give you in the game. Again, I just want to give you guys a really quick warning slash disclaimer. Please, please, please make sure to read and educate yourselves on mods. Even though these add a lot of really fun gameplay options, if anything can go wrong, it will. So please, 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 please read up on it before you do anything in regards to mods. Okay. So, there's going to be three mods I go through today. Nothing too extensive. We're going to be doing Twalin's Master Controller. We're going to be doing the Debug Enabler, and then also the Traveler. Here I am in Sunset Valley. I just opened up a random game. Made it snow and everything because, I don't know, I just wanted to see some weather. some really snowy weather, so... I guess I'll just start off where I left off, I guess. First and foremost, once you have any of, at least Twalin's mods installed, anywhere you click, there will automatically be a new option here that says Naraz. That's his website and everything, and where the mods come from. So this is where you're going to get all your options, in regards to whatever you have installed. Some of them don't show up here. Some are just random, you know, you got to click on certain areas to get them to function correctly. This is basically what you're looking at when you're using Naraz mods. First and foremost, I'm going to start off with a fun one that I know a lot of you are going to like. It's the Traveler mod. So what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to have my sim call up and travel. So, where are we? Phone? No phone settings. Travel. Here we go. Oh, why can't I travel? Save at least once. Oh, yeah. Hold on one sec. Forgot about that. We're gonna go through the Traveler mod, which basically allows you to travel to any worlds you have installed, be them expansion worlds, they could be store worlds, and even the ones from World Adventures. Just a quick note of caution, you have to have World Adventures installed for this function to work properly. So it would be useless if you didn't have that installed. let it save here. And we'll go ahead and check that out. I don't know where I should. I only have one store world installed at the moment, which is Midnight Hollow. Because these are actually my vanilla games where I just go in and do like my guides and stuff. So this is the current game that I have that's only got a few things from the store installed. So, okay, now we can go ahead and travel. Okay, so up here, as you can see, it says select your destination. As you can see, typically when you see this, you would normally see Shang Tsimla, Al Samhara, and then Champsla Sims, which are the worlds from World Adventures. However, if you click on the button, there's other worlds you can visit. We can go to Appaloosa Plains, Bridgeport, Isla Paradiso, and Midnight Hollow, Moonlight Falls. I have all the expansions in. You can go to Sims University. You can go to Starlight Shores, you can go to Twinbrook. Obviously, if you have all the other store worlds installed in your game, those will also show up here. I'm going to select Midnight Hollow. And the really cool thing about Traveler is that, you can stay as long as you want. And it basically allows you to go to these places even if you don't have a certain visa level. So, for example, if we were to go to... China, for example, you can't go more than 3 days because they don't have any visa points. So that part of it stays intact. I'm sure there's some options for you to tweak that, but I'm not sure. That's not anything I've done because I typically, if I want to go to those places, I want to collect visa points and such. But all the other worlds are basically unlocked. for all the Sims to go as long as they want. So, you know, let's say I want to go for 12 days to Midnight Hollow. I can do that. I can go for 3 days, five, so on and so forth. So I'm going to take them to Midnight Hollow, one of my Sims. And just like any other traveling, if you only go with one Sim, obviously your other household stays behind and they don't go with, and everything just remains in place during the time you've left. Yes, we'll overwrite it. So basically it'll save it once again before you leave, so it keeps your game intact. And in the meantime, the Sims that you chose to go on vacation, so to speak, or travel, will actually be going to the other world. This is similar to what they just introduced in Isla Paradiso. But from what I understand, it's a permanent move rather than just a travel, like something like when you're going to the World Adventures world. So, you know, this mod actually gives you a really, really, really a new gameplay experience, because if you're, you know, in Sunset Valley and you're like, you know, I really want to go to Midnight Hollow for, let's say, I don't know, Halloween, you can literally get up and go and it'll take you there. And it's just as simple as that. So once you go there, you have the ability to do everything you can do in any other world. I mean, there's nothing that's restricted. You can buy another home. You could do a bunch of stuff. So it's really cool. I want you to just see how this traveling mod works, just so that you can get a hold of it. Get an idea of what it does. So, all right, well, it's going to probably take a little while to load. I've mentioned in my other videos, this whole saving and loading screen thing has gotten really bad. This far into the series, and I'm on a gaming rig, so I don't know how anybody else tolerates this, but it really irritates me when I have to sit and wait like this forever. But yeah, so this is the Traveler mod. It's pretty cool. I take my Sims on vacation a lot, so it's pretty fun. Especially when you're like, you know, you're bored in your hometown, there's nothing much to do, and you're like, you know what, let's mix it up a little, let's travel somewhere. So this is one of the really good mods for this type of a feature. And like I said before, you have to have World Adventures installed for it to work. So, all right, here we are. So it brought me right to Midnight Hollow. This is actually a new world from the store. So it's asking me now to choose a home lot. Now, let's say you came here and you didn't want to go. You can always go back and it'll take you right back to where you were in your game, which in our case would have been Sunset Valley. So I'm going to select this as my home, and here you go. This is it. This is how it works. From here, you can also, let's go here. You can also travel to another place. So you're not necessarily stuck going to one place and then having to go right back to your hometown and then go out again. You can actually travel directly from here. So let's say you wanted to travel to Isla Paradiso for 12 days. You can do that from here before your time is up. And then from there, you would end up, you can go back to your home again or to another place. So you can literally like go on some kind of like adventure with your Sims and basically, you know, tour the world, so to speak. From here, you also get the option to return home. So it's really that simple. And it's really fun because, you know, look, we just came to Midnight Hollow, and it's like, you know, how often do your Sims get to go to another town, you know, unless you have to move your entire household. So this is really cool. I really like this mod. This gives me additional gameplay that the game doesn't give me on its own. So, well, that's the Traveler mod. So I'll go ahead and end that here. Oh, no, we are not going to place them. I'm not placing anything new. All right. So, I'm going to have you guys take a look at a few other things here. Next up, we're going to check out Debug Enabler. Debug Enabler is, like I was explaining in the last video, it actually offers a debug functionality in the game that typically only developers would have so that they can make things happen. As you can see here on the screen, there's a ton of options. Some of these, I don't even know what they are. I've clicked on them before and I really don't know. I mean, there's stuff in here for, builders and movie tellers and a bunch of stuff. So, I mean, as you can see here, a lot of the things are great. So I'll start off with create. Obviously, as soon as you hit create, look at all the things you have to create. You can create an alien. You can create a sound box, which I don't know what it is. Weather machine. I believe that's something from like Ambition. I don't know. Maybe not. Create a playable Simbot. Create a spirit. So like, let's say, for example, I clicked on that. You can, you know, click on the little spirits from Ambitions. So if you're like, if you have Ambitions installed, you can make the little ghosts appear around your lot, which is really cool because, you know, how fitting is this? We're in Midnight Hollow and there's a ghost. So, you know, you can always, after, you know, you don't want it anymore, you can, you know, get rid of it, stuff like that. So object, there's a bunch of stuff here you can do. I don't know. I know there's a way to delete it, but I'm just going to delete it on my own. So next up, let's see what else is on there. Debug enabler. Create. Insects. Any insects that come in the game, you can definitely just create them out of nowhere. So here's like all the fireflies, butterflies. You could pick any of them. So like this was one of those things where I was telling you, if you are really stuck on finding something in your game, this mod is like awesome because it'll take care of it all for you. Beetles, everything else. I mean, it allows you to basically create anything. You can create large birds. If you have the Sims 3 pets installed, lizards, the rodents, let's see, small birds, snakes, you know, and even the turtle. So, if you have pets installed and you haven't seen all the little, the minor pets that come with the game, well, now you can. Mushrooms. Mushrooms came with The Sims 3 Supernatural. What this will do is it'll actually spawn a random group of mushrooms, nothing specific. That's all I've seen it be able to do. So if you're looking for something in particular, you'll probably just have to spawn it a few times to get what you're looking for. But that's how I've seen it. Let's see. Mushrooms. You can create a playable Grim Reaper. So if I were to select him, he would become part of my household. And he'll show up here fairly soon. Sometimes you won't see what you're asking for right away, but there you go. You can have a playable Grim Reaper in your game. And you can play him, you can do everything as you want with him. And, you know, the best thing about this mod is that, you know, instead of using the game's functionality and trying to cheat him into your household, you know, it's better for you to use the mod because it's set up so that it doesn't ruin anything. He even has his little fog underneath his legs and everything. So there's the Grim Reaper. You can put him in your household and do whatever you want with him. Let's see, what else do we got here? Create. There's gems, rocks, and metals. So, like I said, you can spawn a random selection, or if you're looking for something in particular and you cannot find it, this mod will create it for you. Anything you want from the selection. So this is very useful, especially if you're looking to complete a collection or anything like that. Next up, sea life. This is basically everything that came with Isla Paradiso, with the exception of some that were already in the game, but they were updated with Island Paradise. So, you know, for example, the eels, the hermit crabs, the starfish, stuff like that that you wouldn't normally see are added into this if you have Island Paradise. Seashells came with Island Paradise. You can create any of them. You can create maps in a bottle, messages in a bottle, you know, things that unlock uncharted islands and such, shark tooths, you know, everything that came with the game, it's right in here. Spawn townie maker object. I don't know what that is, to be honest. I don't want to mess with it because I've never really played with it, but wildflowers are another thing. They came with seasons. You can create any of the wildflowers that you want, as well as some trash if you really want some trash on your lawn next to the Grim Reaper and mushrooms. So that's one of the functionalities of Debug Enabler, that it allows you to create things like that you typically have to go around town looking for. All right, there's like options like this: add fire, add a puddle, you know, a regular puddle. So I don't know if it even did anything, but probably not. oh, there it is. I actually had to press play for it to appear. So, you know, you can create a puddle. I mean, there's so many things. I mean, I don't even have enough time to go through everything it does. That was the create thing was one of the major ones. There's bulldoze this lot, burn, unburn tile. So if you want, like, if you're making like a haunted house and you want to burn tile, you can do something like this instead of starting an actual fire. Let's see, display parking, street parking, no. Picture, has a rain butter, leaves. You can create leaves, drop leaves off trees. So, you know, if you don't want to wait, if you have any trees on your lot that are deciduous, I think they're called, where they actually drop their leaves during different times of the year, and you have any, but it's, let's say it's summertime and it's not fall yet and you want them to fall, that'll do that. So another cool thing that that does. Move lot to the game bin. So instead, you know, so let's say, for example, here, I have this household. I want to move them to the bin. Okay, I just did that. And now they're gone. So if you want to move them to the bin and let's say, okay, that's it. And it's no longer a playable house. That's it. You're done. It's over. You can move them right into the bin and end that. So let's, I'm going to hop into Edit Town really quick. And I'm going to get them out because we need them back. where'd they go? Oh, no. All right. Well, there's a failure on my end. They might have gone. Are they showing up as a household? Oh, geez. Well, I don't know. They went somewhere. So I'm going to place down another chick and play with her. So, okay. Let's switch. Yep. Okay, where do you want to live? Oh, there's my family. So they went to the, I guess, so that I can just move them in another place. Something, things like that, you know, it would be something for you to really look into if it's something you're interested in. Because, you know, like I said earlier, you know, see, they're not even showing up in my panel now. So there's things that you, it's probably, you know, they're going to mess up and then you'll like lose your family and stuff. but yeah, really, you know, if I were you, just, you know, do what you know is best, for your game. That's why I said read up on it, because as you can see, even somebody like me, I have no idea what I'm doing. So, all right. I don't even know where my family is. Okay. I'm going to try to get one of these households to let me in. All right. Edit town. Just continue. I'm gonna switch. Okay, place them here. Purchase. Okay. Change. Wow, I really messed this up, didn't I? Yeah, I really messed this up. Oh, they're there. Now they showed up. Okay. Well, that's weird, but anyways. Okay, now they're back. All right. So, you know, like I said, there's a lot of functionality with these mods. And again, please read, because you could see what just happened. I had no idea what I'm doing. all right, let's see. There's, you know, for example, schedule a gig tonight. So if one, if you have Showtime installed and one of your Sims is a singer or magician or anything and you want them to get a gig, boom, you can basically force one to happen. A lot of other stuff. This one's funny. Do lightning strike. Boom. You can create a lightning strike out of nowhere, which is good for storytelling and stuff like that. Let's see, where are we at? Fix invisible Sims, you know, have an NPC visit this lot. One of my favorites is this one, make a Sim. So let's say you have no time to get into create a Sim and you need like some kind of adult right now. You can basically create any type of Sim. So I just created, there he is. It'll show up eventually. But yeah, I just created
Blues.
I just created another Sim that was added to my household. So there he is. Well, he's still invisible, but he's there. you could create Sims. I think, you know, we kind of jacked this up here because of all my manipulating and stuff. So it's not working as it should, but it works when you're just in your hometown and working everything properly. So yeah, you can make Sims out of nowhere. Then you can always take them into create a Sim and, you know, fix them the way you'd like. There's some other stuff here too. I mean, a lot of these are things that, you know, you'd probably, you know, if you really want to look into them, you can study them. So that is it for a debug enabler. I mean, as you can see, it has some really great functionalities. All right, Master Controller. All right, Master Controller is a really great tool. There's so many things to do with it. I don't know where to begin, but I'm going to go through some of the basic things that I use it for, which is I click on any Sims and I go to Master Controller. There's Advanced, Basic, Household, Intermediate, and then Settings. There's a lot of stuff in here. In the Advanced mode, for example, Books, you can, you know, change what songs they know, what books they have written. You can add toddler books, all kinds of things, change their anatomy, copy the skin tone. I don't know what that does. I don't use it. But the biggest thing with this one is edit and cast. I mean, I can click my Sim and boom, it takes me into cast immediately and it gives me the full functionality of Create a Sim. I know that the Sims team added in a cheat. I forgot when, but it was one, maybe pets. I don't know. I might be mistaking, but they added the cheat for you to do this, except the problem with that is a lot of this is cut off. This is actually a full-blown Create a Sim. You could do everything from here like you were from scratch. The only thing you can't do is add any other members to your household from here, but it gives you all your options as if you were, you know, just starting up a new game and creating a Sim. So, I mean, that's something fun or and useful when you're like, you need to change something on your Sim quickly instead of taking them to the dresser and this and that. So I like it. It's a lot easier for me that way. Family. You can add all kinds of, you know, things. I mean, there's a lot here. I don't even know how to even jump into this like I want to. Because you just really need to play around with it to figure it out on your own. But it's so much fun. Here's a good one. I'll use it on Grimmy because I want to take her back home with me. So, Advanced. I can force kill anybody. And basically what you're doing is you're killing them instantly by any death. So if you have any other expansions that add new deaths, that's it. Boom, done. And automatically, their urnstone goes right into the mausoleum, and that's the end of it. They're gone out of your game. So if you really have a Sim that you don't want, that's the way to get rid of them. Your Sims will not get depressed and have that little heartbroken mood lit or any of that stuff. It's just a really great way to get rid of any unwanted Sims. Let's see what else we got in Advanced mode. Randomize skills. Play with genetics. You know, basically, you can play around with all kinds of stuff, meaning you can pick and choose genetics from certain Sims to create, you know, the genetics for your Sim. Randomized skills. So you can basically go in and, you know, pick a bunch of skills and, you know, you're like, okay, I want to do this and that. And here's what happens. You know, your Sim has some skills and it'll randomize them depending on what you wanted them what level you wanted them at. Another one that I use very, very often, obviously you could change traits too here. But this is where the skill level is. Any skills that are in this game, be them hidden or visible in the skill journal, they're all listed here. This also includes any type of skills that come out of the Sims 3 store objects as well. The one thing to be careful with is that when you're using this mod, the skills that from the actual store that are supposed to be visible typically won't be visible. I know that that Twalin really doesn't want to mess with anything when it comes to the store because he's not interested in updating that aspect of it. But, you know, if you use fixes and stuff like that, you can get him to work. But this is where you're going to find all the skills in the game. And anything you want to add to your sim, you can. So if you want to add some handiness skill, some guitar, golfing, jock influence, if you have university, logic, you know, you can highlight anything you want. And as you can see, they're all turning yellow as I click them. Once you click OK, it'll tell you, OK, what level of golfing do you want? What level of this do you want? That, so on and so forth. So, you know, if it says you can pick from 0 to 10, you know, you can put 10 for all of them. 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, and 10. And as you can see now, my sim here, my sim here has a bunch of new skills in her skill journal. So this is one of the really, really neat mods, because I know there's a lot of people out there that are like, oh, how can you raise the skills and get something done a little faster? The Master Controller will take care of that for you. That's pretty much it for the advanced mode. Basic has some basic things. Adopting, Sims, pets. You can check out one's family tree from here. I mean, you could do that anyways, but it's just there for your convenience. You can go home, invite over, money transfer, your mood, you can change your sims, opportunities. You can, you know, force an opportunity to happen, anyone you want that can be in the game. So, you know, you want, you know, anything that's basically related to what they're in. So, you know, if your sim is in a certain career, it'll force an opportunity from that. Another fun thing from here is that you can change their outfits. There's outfits, you know, there's career, everyday, formal day. The naked one is the one when they're like in the shower. So that one appears here too. Swimwear, sleepwear, singed. So like if you want your sim to look like she was singed, give it about a second here and she'll look like she was electrocuted. There you go. It looks like she's happy about that. but yeah, I mean, you can basically change your Sims outfits that quickly. You know, obviously this isn't technically, it's technically an outfit as far as the game's concerned. But it really isn't an outfit, but you know. Let's see, you can pollinate. You can, okay, pollinate. This is a funny one, but you can basically make a Sim pregnant without necessarily woohooing. So you can pick anybody around town and then boom, there you go. She's pregnant. And now she's pollinated and she'll, you know, get pregnant in a day or two. I mean, that's a really quick and easy way to get one of your Sims pregnant without having to go through all that woohoo stuff. Let's see. Remove outfit. Okay. And now, because she is pregnant, you see here an option for the baby showed up. Baby gender. You can set the baby's gender. You can set multiples. So, you can have 30 children at once if you want. you can select the gender or you can randomize it. You know, it's totally up to you. But that's one of the great things about Master Controllers, that you can basically control everything it is that you want to do. There is another option here when it comes to advanced pregnancy. You can end or pause the pregnancy. Now, I know ending the pregnancy is like, you know, if you really want the sim to have your baby, then well, there's no point in doing that. But yeah, let's say your sim is pregnant, but you didn't want them pregnant. You can unpregnant them, I guess. And then you can also pause their pregnancy. So let's say, you know, you're going on a trip and, you know, or you're going to be doing something that doesn't allow for a pregnant sim to do it, you can pause their pregnancy so they can do it. Stuff like that, you know, comes with when your sims are pregnant. So let's see, focus, export. I mean, some of these I don't really use, so I'm not going to get into them because I don't know what they do. The next one is intermediate. This is where you can, like, basically create monsters, really. Instant babies, you can, like, just create a baby from somebody. You can change, you can give them lifetime happiness points. You know, I can give her a million of them, you know, and boom, there you go. She'll have a million. You can change her, I'm sorry, you can change her lifetime wish from here.
She's a deep sea diver, so instead I can go and I can choose anything I want for her to be, just from here. You can go ahead and swap it right out. So let's say you completed one of your lifetime wishes, but you want to do something else now, you could do it right from here. You don't, you know, because I don't think there's really a way to change that at all. And then, you know, oh, 10 million. I gave her 10 million lifetime rewards points, you know, which lets you buy all these fun rewards that come in the game, you know, like rebel influences, stuff like this, all these. So, I mean, I basically just unlock that and I don't have to sit and work my way up for that. Let's see, what else do we have? Gender preference. I don't know. I think that might be have something to do with who your son's attracted to, maybe. Weight, zodiac sign. You could trigger age transition from here. Remove memories. You know, a lot of things that maybe some of you might find useful. Nothing that I've really used, except the lifetime happiness and wish stuff. Gender fitness, favorites, drop opponents. I don't know what this stuff is. Celebrity points, for those of you who have late night and hate those points, you can get rid of them from here, zero. let's see, career. This is another fun one. If your Sim's already in a career, they can actually, you know, switch between levels. But from here, you can pick anything you want. So I'm going to make her a gardener, you know, a self-employed gardener, and that's what she can do. And you can switch from there. Let's see, what else do we have here? There was something else I wanted to check out. Okay, I don't know. There's like, for example, bust size. I've seen people do stuff like this when it comes to their Sims. She basically has like the biggest breasts right now. Like, these are supposedly her breasts. there's a lot of crazy things you can do with Master Controller. Let's go down to something that's like a little more, there we go. Something a little less in your face. This is still in your face. But yeah, I mean, you know, if you really want your Sims to have a big bust, you can definitely do that. There's also, let's see, I think there was something else here about, let me see. Bust size. I don't know. I thought that there was like something, you know, like, oh my God, that's 10, size 10 bust size. And it's like, it's some really weird stuff. But, you know, if you want those options, you have them with Master Controller. Let's see, what else do we have here? Make active settings. There's also settings like this where you can, you know, change everything that you want to do. So, for example, if you're one of those people who wants more than 8 Sims in your house, you can allow for it. Or if you click on it, you would make it false, meaning you won't allow the game to have more than 8. Allow memory creation. You can turn that on and off, true or false. Party age filter. I mean, there's a lot of stuff in here that you can, you know, if you use it, you can basically tweak the game to your liking, and it's probably going to be added some really fun experiences for you. So that's basically it when it comes to like the Sims and stuff. Another fun thing that's one of my favorites is that you can use Master Controller from a house. So let's say somebody lived, I don't know, let's find a house. Oh, we have to have friends or something. Let me make her some friends. Where's the make friends for me. Okay, so let me find the houses of the friends I've just made. And we can really, come on, where are they living? Okay, that's really weird. Well, I know that, like, for example, in like other towns, when I do, you know, there's options to oh no, here we go. I could do this. There we go. Naraz. So let's say you click on, another house in the area that's unoccupied per se. Naraz. Okay. So even if it's occupied, Master Controller, you can make active. So what I just did is I just switched households without having to go to edit town, without having to save everything, without having to to go through the entire process of saving all of that. I literally just switched households. So that's one of the great things about Master Controller is that, you know, boom, now I'm active in this house once again. So, I mean, there's just some really great gameplay options available with these mods. I'm sure there's a lot more out there. a lot more too as well that, you know, that you might find that I don't use because, you know, I really only use them for certain things because technically I, you know, everything else I like to play it out. But yeah, I mean, you can do anything you'd like to do with a lot of these mods. And, you know, Twan's got a bunch of other ones over there as well that you want to check out, like the saver. I think it saves your game every so often. Stuff like that. But this is basically what some of these mods do. This is the cheats that I use in my game when you guys, you know, always ask, oh, how did you raise their skill and do that? So this is what I use. I don't use it during my normal gameplay, but I do use it a lot when I'm doing game guides or overviews or writing, like, you know, reviews and stuff for the website because I need to get through it quicker than just playing the game. So this is everything that there is. So, you know, if you want to check all this out, go ahead and check out the description below. I have links to everything, including Twalin's website. And take a look for yourself. So I hope you guys all enjoyed this. Let me know if there's any other videos you guys would like me to do in the comments below. And that's it for now. So thank you guys for watching, and we'll talk soon. Bye, guys.